Hello, this is a machine learning at home, and I would like to explain how to answer my first assignment. Again, my first assignment was about how to make a train and testing dataset out of the embedded ARIS dataset in such a way that the train dataset will contain 1/3, not 1/5, of data like in the first lesson, but 1/3 of initial data. So we use the same idea of selection rule of logical vector, but we'll make this vector in a slightly different way. So that vector will be like C false true, just three elements, false and true. So that vector, if we apply it to rows of the initial data set, will select each third row, because in R, if we apply that smaller vector for the selection, it will typically recycle row along the data set. And if it will fit exactly into the length of data set, then you will receive no warnings and will have your selection without any fuss. So let us apply this vector to the initial ARIS dataset. I use an arrow up on my keyboard, not to type it again, right? And then I type ARIS, because I'm sure that ARIS data is already present. Type square bracket, because square bracket is for selection. After the logical vector, I will type comma, because before comma will be rows selection. Then I use an empty space, because we don't want to select columns. And close the square bracket. So this is what I will do. But of course, I need to write result in some new object. Let us name it the same way as we did it before. So ARIS train. So this is a different ARIS train, same name, but should be different number of rows. Okay, R didn't say anything. Typically, this means that everything went well. But how to check if ARIS train contains this desired number of rows? So we use command str and look on the number of observations or rows. So now it has 50 observations, 50 rows, which is exactly 1/3 of 150 total observations of the initial data set. So this is the answer. Now we should use the same way exclamation mark for negation, false true, and we'll the false true after negation will turn into true false, and will select first, second, but deselect third row, and so on, because of recycling. And then we use a new test dataset. I can say the test dataset must have 100 observations. Let us check it. Yes, it is. It has 100 observations. So this is the answer. This is how to make selection in order to have a slightly bigger training data set of like 33% of initial data. However, R is famous of doing one thing in multiple ways. Some people dislike it. I personally like it very much. So if you don't want to have more than one answer to your assignment, you can close video now. But those of you which like to hear more about R possibilities can continue to listen, type. Of course, important is to type everything yourself. And of course, look on the screen. So let us do some different way of the same thing. So, well, selection of rows is necessary for making smaller data set out of the bigger data set, right? Okay, rows can be selected in two ways. First way you already learned, that's a logical way we're using logical variable with recycling or without recycling. So in that case, we must create the variable of 150 elements, and then we'll select some new subset of older data set. So sometimes people are tired to type false, false, true, and to avoid typing so much, you can use different approach, which I will show you. So instead of typing false, false, true, we can type 0, 0, 1, and that will, of course, produce three numbers, but we need truth and false, okay? To have truth and false, we can simply say more than 0. That's a logical expression, which must have answers false, false, and true, because 0 is not more than 0. Next 0, of course, is not more than 0, but 1 is more than 0. So this is false, false, true. So what is it? It's another way to make the same logical vector. Let us check how it works. So we make new train. I would call it Iris train 2 out of that 0, 0, 1 more than 0 way. So essentially, we do exactly the same. Let us check if it will have exactly the same result. And then we use our command identical to check if our initial train and a new one is identical. Iris train and Iris train 2. Yes, true. They are identical. So this way, with logical expression, 0, 0, 1 more than 0, looks funny, but works and will require less typing. That's also important because when you type false, you can mistype and type some lowercase letter, but R doesn't understand lowercase letters. It must be all uppercase. So typing 0, 0, 1 is probably less prone to errors, so that's why that way is appropriate. Okay, but that's not only one alternative way, there are more ways. We can select rows by numbers, by indices. So we simply can produce some sequence of numbers which will give us number of each third row. So how to make it? It's easy enough. There is a command seq for sequence. We can start from 1 and end our sequence in a maximal amount of rows. It's actually 150, but more logical would be to place some new smaller command, because in that way our data set will be, our script will be more portable. And row, number of rows. So we start at 1, we'll end at number of rows of Iris, which is 150, and we'll make a step by 3. Let us check how it works. So if we run it, we'll have first row, fourth row, seventh row, tenth row, 13th row, 16th row, and so on. Looks like it is what we want. So it will give us the row number 1, row number 4, row number 7, row number 10, and so on. So we can start at row number 3. And in that case, our selection should be exactly the same as it was with logical vector. So we'll select row number 3, row number 6. And then finally, we'll select row number 150. So let us check if it works. So we apply that same thing to the initial data set, Iris, for rows. and make a new data Aris test tree, train tree, sorry, train tree. Okay. All right. And now we have a third variant of training dataset and can use the same identical one to see. Yes, this is exactly the same thing. So whatever we use, logical vector or numbers, result will be the same. Interesting question, how to use that approach for selection of testing dataset? Well, easy enough. Instead of negation, we must use minus, because minus in our language, minus number, means not to select this one. So instead of exclamation mark, we use minus, and it will be new testing data set. We'll call it test tree. So minus before SEQ means that we do not want row number 3, 6, 9, 12, and so on. Let us see how it works. And then use the same identical command to see if our initial test, in new test, test 3 are identical. Yes, they are identical. So it was not only answer to my assignment, but also two new things. I did show you how to use a logical expression to simplify your typing of logical vectors, and also how to select by numeric indices, by numbers. This is it. Thank you very much.